going to talk about Kinnaird to begin with. Kinnaird today is so different from what it was 111 years ago. 1913 is the year that Kinnaird was established. This was the time the British were here. And Michelle Meskel, who's written a history of Kinnaird, she writes in her book, Celebrating Kinnaird, so she writes that there was no social group that was propagating education for women. The Punjabi woman was not allowed access to education. And that's a fact. Kinnaird College started as a school to begin with. And it was basically to educate basically Bengali Christian women to take up jobs in schools. So that is how Kinnaird developed. Very few students, right up to all the early years before partition, very few girls were being educated. And in fact, it was the girls' insistence that Kinnaird started an FA and later a bachelor's program. When I joined Kinnaird, I won't tell you when, I'll tell you, 1967. Oh, yes. I'm still thriving. So even in 1967, there were only 500 students. Everybody knew each other. And you see, the excellence was set up at Kinnaird very early. In 1920 even, there was a student of Kinnaird who won the All Pakistan Literature Prize. It was a gold medal in 1920. So excellence had been established. With 500 students, it was still an annual system. And students were taking, it wasn't, if we look to the future, the present, higher education is so much more complicated. It was an annual system. There were three books that you had to study, take an exam, and then you're graduated. But even in those days, those women who were here at Kinnaird went out and they were trailblazers. We had the first pilot from Kinnaird, a commercial pilot. We had the first judge. We had authors, we had poets, we had actors, we had singers. I think Kinnaird was already on its way to excellence. I came from a small provincial town, Jhelum. Yes, oh. Small town. And of course, not many women went to college, and certainly not to another city. I don't remember any struggle or hardship that I sort of went through, but I'm sure my parents had to go through something. There were friends, there were relatives who might have said that, where are you sending your girls, so far away? I was only 15. We were both 15, 16, 17. And so they must have gone through something. And also the fact that we were not a terribly well-to-do family, and sending two daughters to study in a boarding must have put some strain. But I'm so glad that my mother and my father saw that educating a girl was the most important thing that they would want to do in their life. So I feel really thankful, full of gratitude, that where I stand today is really, really, truly because of my parents. I came to Kinnair and I was here for 2 years. I did my intermediate here. I did not stay for my bachelor's because Kinnair did not have art. Little did I know, I was 17, walking down the same paths that I walk today, that one day I will be heading Kinnair. I had no clue. I went to the university, did my bachelor's, did my master's, went on to teach at the university, married a well-known artist, started a consultancy firm, design firm, wasn't in academia, and 2001, I came back to Kinnair to give back what Kinnair did not have then. I established the art department at Kinnair. I think that was, even that I never thought I would come back to Kinnair in any capacity, let alone a teacher and consequently a principal, not at all. And that is when I spent 10 years at Kinnair teaching and being the head of the Department of Fine Arts. And I think that that's the time that art really, I'm really, really happy to see the art department today. Just like Kinnair, it has really taken off and has its own identity. Every woman is a multitasker. You do a job, especially career women, you do a job, but you have to take care of all the other things that are required of you as a young woman, a wife, a mother. And same was the case with me. So I was married, I had a child, and I had a job. So juggling that, being a woman, I think that was sometimes hard, but I think your mind is always, should be, stronger than your feelings. Your mind must lead you. I also had some struggles while I was a teacher. I have one child, and sending her away to study was a difficult decision. Meanwhile, my husband had also passed away, so I was by myself. So it was, you know, there's lots of people who tell you, tum isko bhej rahi ho? Hai, kaise rahogi? Kaise hoga? Don't send her so far away. But that was her future. She had to do it. I would not have stepped in and prevented her from a future which is hers. And I think that kind of thing has also helped my position, because I really don't have any responsibilities at home anymore. So all my responsibilities are to do with Kinnair, and I'm so happy about it, because I give my maximum to Kinnair. My time, my thoughts, my energy, my everything. Fast forward to future. Future nobody's seen. Let's stick with the present. The college has grown tremendously. We boast of 5,300 students at this point. I was at the dinner LLF yesterday, and I met this German poet who had been to Kinnair a few years back. And I was thrilled to what he had to tell me. He had come here to speak to the students. And he said, you know, I have never seen students like the students at Kinnaird anywhere. I had to ask him again. I said, what do you mean by anywhere? Do you mean anywhere in the world? He said, yes, that's what I mean. And you can't imagine how elated I was. Not only was I a student, but all of you are students here. You are unique. And I think the institution, all the teachers that we had, all the teachers that we have today, have given you something. There's something in Kinnaird which is different, which sets you apart. Even the other lady, the French lady who was speaking to the students yesterday, even she had a similar, you know, take on the students. She said they're different. So please keep that difference right into the future. Everybody sees the efforts. No, everybody does not see the efforts. Everybody sees success. Integrity, honesty, gratitude, hard work, all those things. And I think to be each one of you has leadership qualities. Leaders, I'll never forget when I was at Harvard for this training, the chair, she told me, you know, it does not matter what degrees you have. It's not your degrees that make you a leader. It's your values. It's your values. It's how you deal with the people that's important. Nobody is going to remember whether you've done a PhD or you're, you know, and from where you've done it, or whether you were first or you did whatever. But they'll remember how you behaved, how you dealt with things, how you dealt with problems, how you dealt with so many things. So really, it's about you. And I think all of you, but I wish all of you the best of everything, and each one of you to become a leader and to lead a life full of energy, full of gratitude, and full of hard work. So thank you.